5 seconds to go. I am delighted to be here today to address the Conference of Governors. This is indeed a unique opportunity for me, as I am of the firm opinion that the office of the governor has been vested with great responsibility by our constitution, and I have the chance today to leave behind some thoughts with you about the evolving nature of the role and functions of this august office. There perhaps no other constitutional office that enjoys the autonomy and carries the attendant responsibility as does that of the governor. In these unstable times we are living in, people have great expectations from this office. This places an enormous burden on your shoulders. It also gives you the opportunity to do good. The role of the governor has varied over time and space and has come under close public scrutiny. The greater the responsibilities attached to an office, the greater will be public scrutiny in a democracy. In our evolving polity, where political patterns have changed substantially over the last 70 years, there is bound to be some partisan controversy or the other challenging the authority and dignity of this high office. This places an added burden on your shoulders to rise above partisan politics while discharging your constitutional obligations. In doing so, you are the sole judges of what is right and wrong, of what is mandated to you as per the constitution and what is not, what is in larger national interest and what is not, and what do people perceive your actions to be. I am sure that each one of you has reflected on this aspect of your work, and am confident that you have the wisdom, experience and sagacity to deal with these situations. Today, India is at height in its development trajectory. After years of the so-called Hindu rate of growth, we have broken fresh ground and have been able to deliver growth in the range of 5%, 6%. We are now at a point in time where we can deliver growth at a rate of 7%, 8%. At this point in time, owing to the developments over the last two decades, there are no external constraints to the growth of our country. It is very much in the realm of possibility for this country to become a prosperous nation, rid of the perennial blot of poverty. In such circumstances, if there are any constraints, these are purely internal. Our success in living up to our potential or not depends on our competence or on our inaptitude. No external force can be blamed if we do not rise up to global expectations. Therefore, I will emphasize that it is an obligation for all of us in this august gathering to reflect on our roles in ensuring that the processes of development are allowed to take place unhindered. It is this vision of a rising India that must guide our actions while discharging our duties.